Revelio. Could bring them. Defend them. Rebellion. Confirm them. Protego.
Ugh. Shame you're so foul.
Is Highwing all right? Natty told me what the two of you did.
Highwing's fine. I'm keeping an eye on her. She's safe, Poppy, I promise.
Good. Whatever the poachers are up to, I want Highwing far from it.
You said you had news about the poachers, and that some of it had to do with me.
It did. I overheard them talking in the Hogshead, and did you know that they have orders from Victor Rookwood to capture you on sight? Does this have anything to do with Rookwood and Harlow coming for you in the Three Broomsticks after the troll attack?
It does, somewhat. But at the moment, I'm more concerned about what else you heard the poachers are up to.
Fair enough. But I hope you'll let me know if I can be of help, especially after what you did for Highwing. Does the name Horntail Hall mean anything to you?
I'm afraid not. Why? What is it?
The poachers' best kept secret, apparently. The name came up twice, but they never went into detail. I also overheard one of them bragging about all the gold they're making, at the expense of innocent creatures, undoubtedly. The poachers spoke of this area, and I thought if we searched around a bit, it might give us clues as to what they're doing. If you ever meet my gran, this trip never happened.
Not to worry, Poppy. If I ever meet your gran, I shall not speak a word of this.
I normally tell her everything. She might be my best friend after Highwing, but she knows how I feel about the poachers. I think she worries I'll do something ill-advised.
Whatever gave her that idea?
This way. A centaur. Tread carefully.
An entire castle to roam, yet you choose to wander here.
Please, we don't want any trouble. We're simply passing through.
Do you take us for fools? That we do not notice more and more of your kind around here, in league with the poachers?
We aren't involved with them. If anything, we want to see them stopped.
I hope for your sake that is true. Our kind is swiftly losing patience with the poachers and those they work with.
He was certainly a charmer.
That could have gone worse. Centaurs aren't exactly fans of wizard kind, and the poachers aren't helping matters.
But why would he think that we had anything to do with poachers?
I did notice the poachers talking with a few villagers in Hogsmeade.
Revelio.
Not sure why. Perhaps that's why the centaurs are suspicious. That's the third time I've seen a Dugbog behave that violently.
It seems that a lot of beasts have been more aggressive than usual lately.
I've noticed that too. It's almost like there's something in the water. This is odd.
What is it?
Not entirely sure, but look around. If the poachers were here, perhaps we can find out why.
Why wouldn't they take their cages with them when they left? Pelt. Still smoking. They can't have been gone long.
Revelio!
This is goblin metal. Seems out of place in a poacher camp. I should tell Poppy about it.
Anything interesting?
Poachers were here. All sorts of evidence. But I found something else. It's goblin made.
I found goblin armor. Let's keep searching, but carefully. Merlin only knows what's going on here. I don't have a good feeling about this. How do goblin and poacher interests align?
Look, down there!
Definitely poachers. No creatures, though. So what are they doing out here?
Let's take a closer look.
They won't be happy to see us. Should we use disillusionment? Or perhaps a less discreet approach?
Hard to say from up here. Let's get a better lay of the land.
It's been ages since I've found anything worth poaching near Crack Rock.
Revelio.
Now, where did I set my traps? Was it Lower Hogsfield?
Oh, that's a brilliant idea.
Ah! Cool air for me all you want, or I shall be off spending this boy.
Come out before I find you. One in...
What in Merlin's name?
Are those dragons?
It's a dragon fighting ring. This is Horntail Hall.
The name makes sense now, and the secrecy.
No wonder the poachers were in Hogsmeade so much. Likely taking bets and spreading the word, given how crowded it is here. How could they possibly enjoy this? The centaurs have every right to be disgusted with wizardkind. There must be more dragons here. The poachers are far too greedy to run a fighting ring with only two dragons. We should take advantage of most eyes being in the fight and look around. But be discreet. You especially can't afford to be spotted.
Have you heard from your family? Has either of your brothers come round to our way of thinking? Will they join us?
Nah, they say we go too far. The violence isn't going to get us what we want. I say, if every last wizard is run through with a blade, then violence is going to get me precisely what I want.
Sickens me to work alongside any of them. Don't know how Ramrock's stomach's being near Rookwood. Foul beast.
Not much longer now. Soon our necks will be out from under wizarding boots. Wizardkind will pay for what they've done.
Did you hear those goblins? Ramrock and the poachers must be working together.
Poppy, something's going on behind you.
What's going on down there? They must have only just captured her. She's putting up quite the fight.
Not a fair one, though. Not with her chained up like that.
Let's even her out, shall we? From the looks of it. We can't leave it here, not with the plans they likely have for it.
Hello, Amora. I have the egg.
Ready. The element of surprise will only buy us a few seconds.
Let's make them count.
Revelio.
Thank you.
when more show up.
Good hold, sir.
Accio.
In black.
I'm guessing the egg we have belongs to that dragon.
I don't think she knew they had her egg. She wouldn't have left without it.
What now? She didn't exactly leave us a calling card.
I don't know. Nothing about this day was expected. Not the goblins and definitely not the fighting ring. The last thing I planned on was a dragon egg. And the poachers saw us, which cannot be good.
Since the dragon we freed flew off, does that mean we get to keep the egg?
I'd much rather we have it than the poachers, at least for now. But I don't think we should keep it indefinitely. It'll be hard hiding something like this from Professor Weasley for long.
Should we expect trouble from the poachers, given the trouble we just caused?
It'd be foolish not to expect it. They're not a forgiving lot. I'm sorry to say that you likely have a larger target on your back now because of what we just did.
We aren't helping ourselves standing here. Let's get to safety. We can sort this out later.
You're right. If there's anything the poachers are good at, it's tracking their prey. And right now, we're it. Be careful, won't you? I shall see you back at the castle.
Lumos. Revelio.
It's time you learned the transformation spell. After you've completed the required tasks, which I'm certain will prove useful in finishing your field guide, attend my class to learn the new spell. Afterwards, we will discuss your progress thus far in the term.
Thank you. Revelio. Rebellion. Arresto momentum.
covering them. The pulse.
My mother would like to speak with me. I believe she has learned about some of what we've been up to. I'm hoping she may be easier on me if you are there.
Can we meet at the Three Broomsticks? It may finally be safe since we rescued the dragon from Horntail Hall.
I should let Deke know about the newborn Thestral. Hello, Deke. You'll be pleased to know that a little Thestral was born.
How wonderful to have more Thestrals in our world. Such misunderstood beasts.
I'm sorry that we can both see Thestrals, Deke.
Deke is privileged to see such majestic beasts, but sometimes wishes Deke couldn't. Deke is to blame.
What do you mean, to blame?
Years ago, Deke's master ordered Deke to help him capture a phoenix, the rarest of all beasts, that Master had spotted high on a cliff. The phoenix was the most beautiful beast Deke had ever seen. Deke begged Master to leave her be. When Deke hesitated to climb up the cliff as ordered, Deke had to punish himself. As Deke punished himself, Master grew angrier and angrier, and in his frustration cast at the regal bird. Deke suspects the phoenix was protecting eggs when it swooped down in fear and fury. Before Deke could reach him, Master fell from the cliff. Deke stayed on that cliffside for days, punishing himself, before Tobbs found him.
What a horrible tale, Deke. I'm so sorry.
Deke has only told Professor Weasley that story, and now yourself. Deke often wonders what became of that phoenix. Deke feels fortunate to be at Hogwarts now, helping you rescue beasts. Perhaps Deke can make amends for what came before.
Revelio.
You're back. Nice to see you again.
Let's look at what we have, shall we? Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Nothing like finding just the right thing, is there? Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Revelio.
Hello? Is something the matter?
Most decidedly, yes. My precious mooncalf, Biscuit, was abducted by Pope... I tried to fight back, but...
I'm sorry about your...
Garnath. Oh, my poor...
I'll keep an eye...
Oh, how kind. If you do see her. Do keep an eye out for her, and be careful out there. Poachers are an unsuitable...
I should try and rescue Garnath's mooncalf. Sounds as if I'd need to head north to find those poachers.
Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. You've a good head for business, haven't you? Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. Now, you let me know if there's anything else I can help you with. No one can say I don't keep a stacked shelf.
Hello. Is there something I can help you with?
How do you do? I'm Saccharissa Tugwood, and I have an exciting business proposition for you. Now, it may surprise you to learn that someone of my obvious esteemed lineage would be in business. But I only want to help the less fortunate.
How magnanimous.
Oh, there's more. You see, I've been experimenting with a new beauty cream. A cream that will rid our glorious school of the hideous, greasy pustules plaguing our poor pubescent classmates. But I've run out of the key ingredient, Boobatuba pus. Boobatubas do grow in the Forbidden Forest, however. If only I could pay someone to collect a few for me.
I can try and find some for you if I have the time.
Marvelous. I'd go myself, but I don't want to. I only need a few Boobatubas, but they grow wild. So you'll have to look around. Our spotty classmates are counting on you, so you mustn't tarry.
Into the Forbidden Forest for the tubers. I think it's worth the risk.
Nothing to poach in Arranger except spiders. Not worth the trouble if you ask me.
This is where Saccharissa said to go. And where are those Boobatubas?
Quit that guy!
Could that have to be an attack of some sort?
That was a mistake.
Where's that goblin helm, you look?
Incendio! Capringo!
They say you're hard. Huh? For quite a...
What would you be needing?
Incendio!
Incendio!
Capringo! Capringo!
Incendio!
No!
You have me!
Incendio! Capringo! Incendio!
Gotcha! Held your own.
Ha!
You gonna loot me! Place it. Incendio to that woman, isn't it?
Incendio!
Take it. Pay for it.
Confringo!
Place it.
Oh, that smells awful. Only four more, thank goodness.
Good for you.
Easy, my large friend.
Revelio.
Bring them.
Rebellion.
That should do it. I'd better get back to Zacharis. Zacharissa, I found the Buha tubers you needed.
Splendid. I hope it wasn't too much trouble. May I have them?
It actually was a spot of trouble. You never mentioned I might encounter a troll. I think you should pay me more.
I suppose a higher price is less offensive than being forced to regard the hideous, greasy pustules plaguing our pubescent classmates. Thank you. And your payment, of course. Now I can begin perfecting my potion to save our poor pimply peers. Don't know who should be more grateful, I or our unsightly spotty classmates. One day the wizarding world will know my name, and you will have been a small part of it.
This could prove dangerous if I'm... Poachers? Garniff was right then. I'd better be careful. Safer now.
Revelio. Reparo. Alohomora.
Which one of you is Biscuit?
Let me also.
All right, Biscuit. Let's get you back to Garniff, shall we?
Repairer. Rebellion. Leviosa. You in some sort of trouble?
Nearly attacked by wolves, I was. Only just escaped with my life. I need to be better prepared next time. Could use some thunder brew. I don't suppose a student...
I'm afraid not.
Well, that is un... Not a charitable bone in their body.
Garneth, I've rescued Biscuit.
You have? Oh, is she hurt? Was she frightened? Are you all right?
Biscuit is fine, as am I.
Oh, mercy. I cannot wait to get...
You can have her back for the right price.
Of course. I would pay any amount for the safety of my dear Biscuit. Oh, my sweet little Biscuit, my wise, noble Mooncalf. And here is your reward, of course. Well deserved. As I said before, you have restored my faith in wizardkind. You've restored at least a modicum of my faith in wizardkind. Biscuit and I can't thank you enough.
Thank you. Revelio.
I'll look after you.
Revelio. Rebellion.
Revelio. I should investigate. Assignment's all finished.
Revelio. Levioso. Revelio.
This looks intriguing.
The pulsar!
Wingardium Leviosa! Wingardium Leviosa. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio. Leviosa. Incendio. Revelio.
Everything's all right now.
Revelio.
Who lived here?
The fog blighted us a bit, I'll agree.
I'd rob my own father if there were galleons in it. Not my mother, mind.
What's that? Better have a look then.
Miracles, don't tell us.
Can't let anyone get past me this time.
Akio.
Somebody out there?
Revelio.
Where is she?
Miracles, don't tell us. Don't tell us.
again. Practicus Totalus. Revelio.
Of time.
The castle must have been quite stately in its time.
Practicus Totalus!
I've robbed every traveling vendor that's...
Shame nobody...
Revelio. Revelio. Confringo. Revelio.
Abandoned long ago, no doubt.
Revelio. Accio. Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio.
these rocks have seen better days.
Excellent work today. Class dismissed. I take it you're ready to learn your new spec.
I completed your assignment, Professor. I'm ready to learn Bombarda now.
Good. Now, this spell comes with a caveat. It should only be used when necessary. The exploding charm, as you might suspect, can hurt people. Use caution when casting it.
I will, Professor.
I will hold you to that promise. Now, you must be precise in your wand movements. We don't... Nice and steady wand movements. Remember, the exploding charm is highly volatile. Well done! Let us put it into practice, shall we? Go ahead and try it.
Bombarda!
Excellent wand work. Confringer! Like that every time. Assured and...
Bombarda!
Thank you. How nice to see you, my young friend.
How much longer do you think Black will be headmaster? My family.
Revelio!
Oh, my God, he's gone.
Confringo!
Good
for you.
That one, haven't you? Good thing, Professor Weasley.
Revelio. Rebellion.
Yeah.
So this is the underground harbor.
Revelio. Revelio. Professor Weasley asked me to find should be around here somewhere.
Looking for the book Intermediate Transfer.
Professor Weasley asked me to get something from that book. May I have it?
Did she now? I'll give you this book if you humor me by answering a few questions from my quiz.
Quiz?
Some people call bits of knowledge trivia. I would argue that no knowledge is trivial. Hence, I have created a small quiz. Just for fun, focusing mainly on the lore of the Wizarding World. None of the other students will try it, no matter how many times I ask. They all say they have enough with schoolwork. Ugh, they don't value knowledge the way I do. Surely you're interested. I'll even start you off with a few of my easiest questions.
If that's the only way I can convince you to give me that book, then let's get it over with.
Splendid! Just a few questions, and then I'll hand over this book. Let us begin. Before the invention of the Golden Snitch, which magical creature was used in a game of Quidditch?
The snake bird.
No, incorrect. The answer was the Golden Snidget. The Snidget was first introduced to Quidditch in 1269 by a wizard named Barbarous Bragg. Sadly, they're thought to be extinct. Next question. Which potion is commonly referred to as liquid luck?
Felix Felicis.
Well done. Since it makes the drinker temporarily lucky, Felix Felicis is a banned substance in all organized competitions. The tale of the three brothers involves which magical artifacts?
Horcruxes.
No, the answer was the Deathly Hallows. According to Beedle the Bard, the Deathly Hallows consists of the Elder Wand, the Resurrection Stone, and the Cloak of Invisibility. Which ball in Quidditch is the largest?
The Bludger.
I'm sorry, but the correct answer was the Quaffle. When a chaser throws the Quaffle through one of three, true or false, Polyjuice Potion allows the drinker to change species.
True.
While Polyjuice Potion... Well, I suppose this has gone on. If you're inclined to test your knowledge again, And I won't be giving you any more easy questions either.
I'm sorry.
Let me know if you change your mind. I put the book back on the pedestal for you.
Revelio ought to make quick work of this. Professor Weasley's tasks are complete. I should attend Transfiguration.
An answer as to why that portrait was empty.
Bombarder!
Could you remind me how the Dedalian keys work again?
When you spot or hear a... I hope you follow some...
Revelio.
I swear we'd be more uplifted in the potions if we
I heard Professor Weasley translated the book with all her test answers.
Unfortunately, no. In fact, a few days... I was only testing a new recipe in a, mostly.
You don't create anything worthwhile without setting...
Agreed. Innovators like... Can't let the doubters sway me. Oh, that gives...
Settle down, settle down. Transfiguration, as you may be weary of hearing me say, is an exact science that can take a lifetime to master. But we needn't be daunted. Almost anything can be transformed if you can just perceive the potential within it. As I see in all of you, tremendous witches and wizards, every one of you. Or it could just be my eyesight. Now, you all know what to do.
Beautifully done.
You wanted to discuss my progress so far this term, Professor.
I did. You seem to have had no trouble in getting up to speed. And frankly, excelling in your schoolwork this year.
Thank you, Professor. The extra assignments have been helpful.
As I suspected they would be. Now, it seems you've been making good use of the opportunities presented by your field guide. Of course, the guide isn't the only measure of success. I've heard that you were able to grow a venomous tentacular. Growing such a magical plant is an accomplishment of which you can be quite proud.
Thank you, Professor.
I will say I'm especially impressed with all you've accomplished in light of the rumours of your extracurricular activities. Was your extended conversation with Mr. Ollivander after you'd obtained your wand, or subsequent search of the owlery, connected in any way to Professor Fig?
Not at all. I enjoy talking to Mr. Ollivander. I'm fascinated by a wand lore, and I'd never visited the owlery. Bit of a mess.
I see. I admire your penchant for learning, but do remember that your classwork and field guide are designed to educate you thoroughly. It'll be the end of the year in no time, and you'll want to be well prepared for your OWLs. I'll provide a final assessment at that time to ensure that you're ready for your exams. Until then, well done. You are dismissed.
Since our visit to Feldcroft, something dawned on me about the triptych. Maybe at the Overlook, just north of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll explain.
My plan with the helmet failed, but I have another idea. I think we may be able to find what we need at a goblin mine south of Hogwarts. Meet me there, and bring someone who speaks gobbledygook.
You'll never believe what I...
What did you discover in the spellbook we found in the scriptorium?
Salazar Slytherin's spellbook was a little difficult to interpret, but fascinating. Evidently, he encouraged teaching dark magic at Hogwarts. Neither the Imperious Curse nor the Killing Curse was unforgivable during his time. He believed students should be prepared to use dark magic when necessary, not to fear it. That's why we had to use Crucio to gain access to the scriptorium. He didn't want his knowledge shared with anyone who was afraid of the power of dark magic.
It was hard to do, but casting Crucio was our only option.
And I'm glad we did it, because in the spellbook I also found something else. References to a lost relic, which, from what I can tell, grants the holder the power to reverse dark magic curses.
And you think this relic might be able to save Anne?
Precisely. I plan to search for this relic, but I don't think we should tell anyone. Especially ominous. He wouldn't understand.
I see no reason to involve ominous.
I'm glad you agree. When I know more, I shall send an owl. And don't feel sorry for ominous. Ourselves for now is for his own good.
I'll decide what's for my own good.
Ominous, we were just about to get some air. Care to join?
You're a liar, Sebastian. I heard everything. You swore you'd never engage in anything to do with dark magic again.
Revelio. No, I didn't. I said I understood you wanting that. I'd never swear to give up on finding a cure for Anne.
You don't know when to stop, do you?
I know when not to stop. Leave this alone, Ominous. I'll be on my way.
I am not letting this go.
Ominous, Sebastian meant well.
I know what I heard. You knew I wouldn't agree with this. Going after that relic is not a good idea. Sebastian doesn't even realize it, but he's as irresponsible and reckless now as his parents were years ago. It's why they died.
I knew his parents died, but I never heard what happened.
Mr. and Mrs. Sallow were professors. Spent nearly every waking moment in the cellar library. Noses buried in books. Anne and Sebastian were upstairs when it happened. They heard a sudden crash and ran downstairs, but it was too late. Their parents had crumpled to the floor. A defect with the lamp in the cellar caused the room to fill with an undetectable toxin. Sebastian and Anne were helpless. They had no magic yet.
What a horrible story.
It is. That's why I can't understand Sebastian's recklessness. I've practically lost Anne. I cannot lose Sebastian too. Please avoid anything to do with that spellbook.
Those references in the book seem promising.
Everything to do with Salazar Slytherin seems promising until it's too late. I hope Sebastian pursues this no further, but if you think he might, please let me know. It would mean a lot.
Bombarda.
Spare a moment? I could use your help.
You wanted to speak with me?
I did. Hello, I'm Duncan Hobhouse. Pleasure to meet you. I've heard all about you, of course, confronting trolls and dragons.
That's nice to hear. I have had my share of adventure. I hope my reputation's warranted.
I'm going to presume your reputation is, in fact, warranted. You see, we were learning to repel boggarts in Professor Heckett's class, and, well, mine unfortunately took the shape of a puffskeen.
Surely you're joking. You can't possibly be afraid of a puffskeen.
It may seem irrational to you, but my experience with them has been most upsetting. They eat bogies, you know. Regardless of how reasonable I believe my fear of puffskeens to be, I'm beginning to get a reputation as a...
I'm sorry, but you have to admit that's rather clever.
I do not have to admit that. Anyway, to make matters worse, I stupidly blurted out that I must be braver than people think, since I have been in the Hidden Herbology Corridor.
The Hidden Herbology Corridor?
Yes. Rumor has it that the herbology professor before Professor Garlic kept dangerous plants there. It's supposedly so overrun now that no... I was hoping you could go there and bring back evidence. Say a bit of an exception.
Very well, if I...
Grand.
Accio. Hidden Herbology Corridor. Sounds intriguing.
Bombarda! Depulsor!
I really have made a mess of
things. Is everything all right?
Oh, hello. Thank you for asking. I'm Cress. You see, I'm fond of creating my own charms. Thought I'd perfected my light as a feather charm to use on my... My arms get so tired. But I must have confused the Latin word for feather with bird in my incantation, because...
That sounds a rather complicated way to simply...
Possibly. But where's the fun in simplicity? New charms and spells have to come from some... I collect the books and remove the charm myself. Except this isn't the first time one of my... Our meat told Madame Scribner they were my books flying around. So she said that if I caused her any more trouble, she'd... Perhaps you could get them for me. There are only five.
I suppose I could help.
Oh, I'd very much appreciate... If you could collect...
Confringo!
You can do better than that.
I'm going to have to use Accio to get the... Got it. Only four more to go.
Revelio.
This must be Cressida's diary. I'd want this back too if I were her.
That's it. Revelio. Accio. Lumos. Rebellion. Accio.
That's the last book. Now to take them back to Cressida.
Lumos.
Reading can be as magical as any spell. Why can't students see that?
Hello, Cressida. I collect...
Oh, what a relief. I'll happily take the heavy...
Unless you want your classmates to know how you really feel about them, you might reward me for my time.
Oh, you're not at all who I thought you to be.
I wouldn't do that to you, Cressida. Only trying to teach you to be a little more careful.
Well, lesson learned. I certainly won't be practicing any... Now, to work out where... Perhaps I should start... Thank goodness some people are trustworthy. Certainly.
Thank you. you in some sort of trouble?
Nearly attacked by wolves.
I don't suppose a student...
Yes, I have some right here. Please take it and be careful.
I feel better already, just know... Please take this as thanks for your generosity.
Anna's getting worse. If there is any chance that the relic from Slytherin's spellbook can help her, I must find it. I'm requesting your help. Meet me outside of Feldcroft, near the catacomb.
That's been a pleasure.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you as well.
What do you have for sale?
What are we in the market for today? Now, if you like what you bought, be sure to come in and see me again. Mentioned you're welcome to stop by.
What's that? Who's there? No!
I will make you pay.
I wonder if I'm safe to explore in there.
You're here. Good.
Sebastian, that relic you mentioned...
I believe one of Slytherin's students stumbled upon the relic during an assignment to study sarcophagi in this catacomb. From what I read in a report by the student, they weren't permitted to take it with them, so I must assume it's still here. As I mentioned earlier, this relic grants its holder the power to reverse dark magic curses. If it's in this catacomb, I have to find it. For Anne, I need to see her.
I'd be interested to know what else the student discovered.
Have a look. Unfortunately, there's no name on it, but I suspect if it was important enough for Slytherin to stash in his spellbook, it's worthy of further study.
I'm ready to explore the catacomb. Perhaps we can visit Anne when we've finished.
Perfect. By the way, Ominous has been asking about you. You didn't tell him what we were doing, did you?
I didn't. I promise.
Good. Ominous would be livid if he knew what we were about to do. I'll be interested to compare what lies inside to what I've read about.